This team will become heroes if you do your job. Do y'all remember the prayer the Bull Bars did last year? Y'all remember that? Raise your hands if you remember that in the locker room. Before we left, come up here. The emotion. The pull from inner strength. Just care about your teammate. Care about the person beside you. Care about your person. I like being in this role. Glad there's people starting to dance. That's when we play our best.
Stay tuned on three. Stay tuned on three. 1, 2, 3.
Stay tuned.
Hey, family three, 1, 2, 3.
Hey, listen, one thing right quick. Listen to me, Jay, you got to hear me. Listen to me.
Don't let little bitty things distract you. In other words, like, I've already heard stuff about you, my blood, or my kids, or my dad. I mean, just certain things just can't, you know, we overcame so much at Camden, nothing tonight should affect us or stop us. The field's in great shape.
Oh, yeah.
We got a great official staff. I mean, they don't want to blow a call, but it's not going to be intentional. And so we've got the best setup. I appreciate your approach today. It has been outstanding. Now, the one thing now, I don't want to have drive to affect us. I want to gear back up. But I felt like when we left at 3:30, we got on that bus ready to go. So you got to re-gear back up. But you know what? Nothing matters until 7:38. That's when kickoff is, 7:38. Great job.
I do not believe that any of us have dreams that were not given to us for the purpose of accomplishing those particular dreams. I don't know what that dream is that you have. I don't care how far-fetched it might appear to be. I don't care how disappointing it might have been as you've been working toward that dream. But here's what I know, that dream that you're holding in your mind, that it's possible. Life has a special kind of meaning. And here's what I will share with you, that in the process of working on your dreams, you are going to incur a lot of disappointment, a lot of failure, a lot of pain, a lot of setbacks, a lot of defeats. But in the process of doing that, you will discover some things about yourself that you don't know right now. What you will realize is that you have greatness within you. What you'll realize is that you're more powerful than you can ever begin to imagine. What you will realize is that you're greater than your circumstances. So I applaud you for your dreaming, for your running toward your dream. I applaud you for believing in yourself, because that's what life is about, stretching and challenging, looking for ways that you can begin to improve yourself, that you work your system, that you are relentless, that you never give up. It's you. You've got to take personal responsibility. You've got to make it your personal business to make it happen. And you've got to resolve within yourself that I can do this. You've got to be hungry. You got to be hungry. It's not over until I win. The people that are running after their dream know they're going to have hard times. They keep on running because they're saying within themselves, I'm the one. I'm the one. No matter how bad it is or how bad it gets, I'm going to make it. The people that are running after their dreams are the people that are hungry. It's not over until I win. It's not over until I win. It's not over until I win. That if you want a thing bad enough to go out and fight for it, to work day and night for it, to give up your time, your peace, and your sleep for it, if all that you dream and scheme is about it, and life seems useless and worthless without it, and if you gladly sweat for it and fret for it and plan for it and lose all your terror of the opposition for it, and if you simply go after that thing that you want with all of your capacity, strength and sagacity, faith, hope, and confidence, and stern pertinacity, if neither cold poverty, famish, or gulf, sickness, or pain, or body and brain can keep you away from the thing that you want, if dogged and grim, you besiege and beset it, with the help of God, you'll get it.